All right, it's Cool FM's Jingle Ball 2013. Delighted now to be sitting beside a man I'm a huge fan of. I genuinely mean that. It's not often I can say that with everyone in an interview, but it's true with you. John Newman. Make some noise for John Newman in the room. There we go. I think that's the best noise we got all night. These guys are here. So how are you, man? Welcome to Belfast.
I'm good, man. I'm really good. I'm tired. We came from London, a big show last night, and then we're here. But it's really good to be here, and it's nice. And I don't know, too much opportunity to come to Ireland, so it's really nice to be able to come and do something like this here.
So I get you say big show last night, it's big show after big show for you now.
It is, really? I think we're in a really important part of the year as well. I think it's kind of summing up 2013, so yeah, I mean, I'm on the Royal Variety performance right now, so it's a bit mad, but...
you've probably been asked this a few times, because you have almost, you've went so quickly into this massive mainstream realm. Do you ever take a step back and kind of like, how did this all happen so quick?
No, I think you get this often get this thing with this whole world that we live in, where people turn around and say, "Oh, you're living the dream." But I try not to think that, because dreams kind of end in the morning, and I work really, really hard for what I do, and I've worked for it for a long time. So I think to me it does feel like a natural progression and a long time coming. But it has happened really, really quickly, and definitely to the public eye. I mean, it's happened very, very quickly. And the thing was, I came on the scene with the Rudimental guys, but I wasn't introduced to the press almost. So my face has hit everywhere quite quickly.
Because you're right, because it was The Voice before that, I suppose, before, you know, and your voice is so unique and kind of very soulful, inspired, I guess. With regards to the Rudimental stuff, that just fitted for you to do that. Did they approach you after hearing your voice?
No, we're just a group of friends that enjoy making music, and it's like, that was the funny thing. We just made some tunes, and then everyone turned around in the music industry and started going, "Well, you're Rudimental," and it got all a bit political. But I don't know, man. We made some good music together, and are definitely up for doing that again.
Yeah, so. Absolutely. Well, I was going to ask that actually in the future. You're obviously all about your own album at the moment and stuff, but you seem like a kind of guy who's really open to collaboration. And you know, have you anything in mind that you'd like to do? Because you seem to break the boundaries a little bit with that soulful kind of drum and bass, everything mashed together vibe.
Yeah, and I don't think it's just my voice that I wanted to start collaborating with. I mean, I love producing and I love songwriting and lots of other things. But I think with my album, I wanted, if it did get to number one, which it did, which is incredible, if it got to that position, I could turn around on that day and just feel so proud of what I'd done. And I'd be really scared if I were to put a big name on that album that it got to number one for a different reason, for the person that was on there and not me. So I genuinely did feel really proud that I'd done it by myself. But now I'm kind of cool. I'm open to offers and to have a play around and get to know some people.
The album itself obviously doing really well, and the new single and stuff, it does kind of have, I've already mentioned it, I know, that kind of soulful vibe. With anyone who hasn't picked up the album just yet or hasn't seen you live, is an all-encompassing kind of sound that you have on albums and live shows? I mean, is that something that you intentionally did, or did you just sit down and it all just came out?
I think you've got to be reasonably natural and let it be kind of organic, and that's what the whole Rudimental thing was as well, when we kind of merged them two sounds that we'd both been working on. And with my stuff, it just grew and grew and grew from the 90s house stuff I was listening to the soul music and everything really, even modern pop. And I just let it brew, but it was Love Me Again was the first production where I knew, I've got it, this is me, and I'm happy where I am, you know.
Brilliant, okay, well great, well listen, welcome to Belfast, thank you so much for doing our Jingle Ball, and you've your own tour, of course, coming up as well.
Yeah.
And you're going to be looking forward to that, no doubt.
I am, definitely. It's going to be nice to go up in venue, so it's going to be great.
All right, well, let's have a great gig later on.
Thank you,
for joining
us. Cheers.
John Newman, everybody. Cheers. Thank you.